Today in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. So I want us to respect the word of the Lord, even by bowing down, and then we shall pray together, because there is power in the sharing of the word of the living God. And therefore, let us pray in Jesus' name. We can lift up our hands as a sign of faith. If you have opportunity, you can even raise both of your hands, so that we be in agreement in the mighty name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, I want to thank you. We humble ourselves before you today, and we thank you because of even of sharing of your word. Your word is truth this morning. Your word brings light. Your word brings revelation. Your word comes with wisdom. Your word comes with understanding. Help us, Lord, to understand even the deep things, even the mystery of Jesus Christ. I bless our viewers, everlasting Lord. I bless them that are here with us today. I bless the children in the mighty name of Jesus. I bless the young mothers in Jesus' mighty name. I bless the men in the mighty name of Jesus. And I bless even our youth in the mighty name of the living God. Thank you because of your peace. Thank you because of the opportunity even to share your word today. Receive all the praise and receive all the glory, for it is in the mighty name of the living God we pray and give thanks. Somebody say amen. Somebody say amen in the mighty name of Jesus. So we want to read, we want to continue where we left last Sunday. I believe we are going to be blessed in Jesus' name. So let's welcome the word of the Lord, even by clapping our hands in Jesus' mighty name. We can clap better than that in Jesus' name. We can do better than that in Jesus' mighty name. Let's read from the book of 2 Corinthians. 2 Corinthians chapter number 5. From verse number 17. We are talking about reconciliation. Reconciliation appears many times in the Bible. It appears several times in the Bible. There is purpose for this word reconciliation. And as we are going to be led by the Holy Spirit, let's get the revelation. Let's get the understanding even of this word today in Jesus' name. So this is the reading from NIV version. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. The old has gone. The new is here. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ, and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. Verse 19, that God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, not counting people's sins against them, and he has committed to us the message of reconciliation. God has committed to us the message of reconciliation. So wherever you are today, for us who are present here, and for us who are present even online, let's understand this in depth of reconciliation. Reconciliation is very key to each one's life today. Because when reconciliation comes in, reconciliation comes with peace. Reconciliation comes with love. Reconciliation comes with a lot of harmony. Reconciliation comes with unity. And when we are reconciled back together, there is that joy. There is that love. There is that oneness. There is that energy. There is that strength. There is that liberty where people have been reconciled. When you are reconciled to your maker, you get everything that you need. And that is why we need the presence. We need to understand the ministry of reconciliation. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ Jesus, the new creation has come. The old is fading away and new is here together with us. So in other words, when you are being saved, when you are being, the word salvation comes out of repentance. Or there's these two words, forgiveness and reconciliation. You ask for forgiveness first. In other words, why do you need forgiveness? Because you have been apart with one another,
or
sin comes with separation. The best thing sin does in our life, it separates us from the word God in Genesis. The will of God is always for us to be in His presence. When He created Adam and Eve, He created them and put them in Eden. And there they were rejoicing. They had the liberty of the presence of the living God. And where the presence of the Lord is, there is that fullness of joy. When God is present in your situation, then you have all that you need. Then you have everything because you are with Him. But when sin came in, it separated us from the presence of our Father. It separated us from the presence of our Maker. And therefore, through Christ Jesus, the work of the cross is to reconcile us, is to bring us back to our Father. Just the same grace the prodigal son was reconciled back to his father. And when he was reconciled back to his father, he had everything he needed. He was restored. He was renewed. That is why when we are in Christ Jesus, we are born again. We are living a new life. When one is in Christ Jesus, the old life is fading away. But we get a new life in Christ Jesus. Brethren, the word reconciliation, its root word, it means aloso, that is in Greek. The meaning common to this word, the meaning that is common to this word, it means change. Or even exchange. By the way, those who are doing accountants, those who do a lot of accountabilities or accountants work, those who deal with lots of money, this word exchange is so common to them. It comes with balancing the incomes and even the outcome. Accountability, accountancy is not my profession today. But those who do the work of accountants, they are very familiar with this word reconciliation, because they have to put in order the things that their income and their expenditures, and therefore there is that word exchange. The word exchange is what we are calling reconciliation and bringing things into a balance. So reconciliation involves a change. Reconciliation involves a change in the relationship between God and man. Relationship between God and man. Relationship between man and man. Even we as men and men, many of the times we are not in agreement. Many of the times we are separated in one way or the other. We are not agreeing in anything. But it is the will of the Lord that but we sing in one voice. We speak one language. We be in one accord. We be in unity. Where there is harmony, the husband and the wife, they are in harmony. The children and their parents, they are in one accord. Remember what we have been sharing from the book of Malachi, that it is the will of our Father to reconcile the hearts of children, the hearts of children to their parents, and the hearts of parents to their children, in the mighty name of Jesus. So wherever you are today, let's understand this ministry of reconciliation, because reconciliation comes by the cross of Christ. That is what we have read from verse 18, from 2 Corinthians chapter number 5, verse number 18. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. Remember, the message of the cross is the ministry of Christ. It is the doing of Christ in our life. And this is what I want us to understand deeply today. This is what the Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 18. For the message of the cross is foolishness to them that are perishing, but to us who are being saved, it is the power of God. The ministry of the cross, it is foolishness. The message of the cross, it is foolishness to them that are perishing. But unto us today, it is the power of God. It is the power that comes with healing. It is the power that comes with refreshing. It is the power that comes with a lot of wisdom. It is the power full of love. Oh, I love the song that we sing, that I have a message from the Lord. I have a message from the Lord. A message to all of us today, that you can look and believe. The message of the cross, it is foolishness to them that are perishing, but unto us who are being born again, it is the power. There has been a lot of disconnect. You know, that is what sin, the work of sin, is to separate. Brethren who are living in harmony, they find themselves separated. They find themselves no longer in harmony because of sin that was there. But it is Christ has come to reconcile us back to the Father. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. I'm encouraged by the word in the book of Romans chapter number 12. Let's look at Romans chapter number 12. Romans chapter 12 and verse number 2, or even verse 1 and 2. Therefore I urge you, brethren, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. And verse number 2, this is what the Bible says: do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve God's will, His good, pleasing and perfect will. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be ye transformed, or be ye renewed. Renewal is change. And be ye reconciled. Oh, let your mind be reconciled. You know, many of us, what we are talking might not be the same in our mind. Hallelujah. Some people talk some things that when you look at them, there is a lot of disconnect. So we have to be in that harmony. We have to be reconciled in whatever we do in Jesus' mighty name. We should not conform to the pattern of this world. The world is full of lust. The world is full of envy. The world is full of jealousy. The world is full of hatred. But we need to be reconciled back to one another. To live in love. To live in love. To live in perfect peace. To live in harmony with one another. To love our neighbors. The Bible has not said that we should choose our neighbors. The Bible has not said that we should choose who is coming to be my neighbor very soon. But whoever is my neighbor, the word of the Lord is commanding all of us to love our neighbors. Shupige bwana makofi mazuri. Upende jirani yako. You should love your neighbor. Look at your left, look at your right. Who is seated at your right and who is seated at your left? You are commanded to love your neighbor. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the Bible says if you love your neighbor, then you cannot steal from him. If you love your neighbor, you cannot cheat on him. If you love your neighbor, there's no way you are going to kill your neighbor. If truly you love your neighbor, I'm encouraged by our Lord's prayer. It is full of forgiveness. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says, do to others as you like them do unto you. Praise be to the name of the living God. So if you need love, therefore preach love. Talk about love. Walk the journey of love in the mighty name of Jesus. So in this topic of reconciliation, there are several scriptures. Reconciliation is also related to justification. God has reconciled the world, not counting people's sins against them. It is related to justification. Let us look at Romans chapter number 5. Let us look at Romans chapter number 5. Think from verse number 6 there. This is what the Bible says. Romans chapter 5 from verse number 6 there. You see, at the right time, when we were still powerless, Christ died for the ungodly. Very rarely will anyone die for a righteous person. Though for a good person, someone might possibly die to him. I want us to repeat there again. Very rarely will anyone die for a righteous person. Though for a good person, hallelujah, for a good person, someone might possibly dare to die. Verse number 8 of Romans chapter number 5. But God demonstrates his own love to us in this: while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Hey, while we were still sinners. You know, we don't love God because we loved him first. He first loved us. Pigia tu bwana makofi mazuri. God is in a business of loving you. He has loved us with an everlasting love. Somewhere in the book of Isaiah, the Bible says, in a short moment, I hid myself from you. In a short moment, I had hid myself from you. But for everlasting life, but because of everlasting life, I am coming back to love you once more, even to reconcile you. So reconciliation comes with justice in the mighty name of Jesus. Since we have now been justified by his blood, how much more shall we be saved from God's wrath through him? The blood of Jesus Christ cleanses us from all evil. When they were crucifying Jesus on the cross, his blood was coming down. When they were beating him, Christ was shedding that blood. That blood is what washes away our sins. That blood is the blood of the new covenant. What can wash away our sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus Christ. Shall we celebrate by clapping to the Lord? Just thanking him because of his blood. That blood is bringing renewal unto us. That blood is washing all our sins away. That blood is reconciling us back again. Remember this. There is no remission of sins. There is no forgiveness of sins without the shedding of blood. So today, my brother, my sister, you don't need to shed your blood anymore. You don't need the blood of the bulls, but the blood of Jesus Christ. The blood of Jesus Christ has cleansed us from all evil. So we are free in Christ Jesus. He is our strong tower. Jesus is our revival. Jesus is our renewal today. Jesus is our reconciliator. Jesus is our wisdom today. Hallelujah, in the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus is our redemption. So in Christ Jesus, we have everything that we need. In the mighty name of Jesus. Reconciliation comes with is related with justice. All this is by faith even today. Even our faith that has overcome the world. So reconciliation is very important. Brethren, I know many of us have been talking about going to heaven. I know we are talking of going to heaven. But there is no heaven if you have not asked for forgiveness. There is no heaven if you have not asked for forgiveness. The Bible is very key in forgiving. Hallelujah. Forgive us our sins, even as we forgive our debtors. So I challenge us this year. I challenge us this month. May you have the heart of forgiveness. Be ready to forgive your brother. Be ready to forgive your sister. Be ready to love them. Even them that hate you, love them more in Jesus' name. Even them that are backbiting you, oh, love them in Jesus' name. Do not revenge. Revenge belongs to our God. Revenge belongs to Jesus Christ. So leave revenge to the Lord God Almighty. The battle belongs to the Lord. And because we are in Christ Jesus, we have a renewed heart. We are renewed. We are empowered in Jesus' mighty name. This is what the Bible says in Ephesians chapter number 6. Hallelujah. It is the cross of Christ that reconciled both the Jew and the Gentile. The Jew and the Gentile. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus. Reconciliation. It reconciles the Jews and even the Gentiles. So it is my prayer, if you are looking for blessings, be reconciled back to your Father. He has everything that we need. I am encouraged once again by the prodigal son. Yes, he was given his inheritance, and when he was outside the presence of the Father, he spent it all. But when he was back in the presence of the Father, he had everything that he had ever desired. He was given a new cloth. He was given a new house. A celebration was made. A feast was made. No wonder the scripture says, heaven comes to a standstill when one gives his life to Jesus Christ. Praise be to the name of the living God. You know, the Father was standstill. He looked from a distance. And I'm seeing God is looking at your heart today. From a distance, God is seeing you. Because you are going to have a heart of reconciliation. You are going to have a heart of forgiveness. Hallelujah. A heart of loving even your haters in Jesus' name. We don't pay hatred by hatred. To them that are stealing for us, we love them more in Jesus' name. To them that are speaking against us, we bless them in Jesus' mighty name. So we have a ministry of reconciliation, of bringing those who are not in one accord, those who are in opposition, bringing them together in one table once again. And we are welcoming them to the Lord's table today, that be reconciled back to your Father. In the mighty name of Jesus, we are not going to escape without the attitude, without the heart of forgiveness, without the heart of loving one another. Praise be to the name of the living God. Why carry people anymore in your heart? Oh, reward them with love. Speak blessings in Jesus' name. So reconciliation is very, very important. I have several more scriptures here for us. 1 Corinthians chapter 7 and verse number 10. To the married I give this command. A wife must not separate from her husband. But if he does, but if she must remain, or else be reconciled to her husband. And the husband and must not divorce his wife.
No,
if they had divorced or separated, then they need to reconcile back together. And they need to come back together in the name of Jesus. Colossians chapter 1 and verse 20-22. And through him to reconcile to himself all things. That is Jesus Christ. Reconciling all things back to himself. Whether things on earth or things in heaven, by making peace through his blood shed on the cross. Remember the cross. The cross is all about Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the message of the cross, that is where the blood was shed. Once you were alienated from God and were enemies in your minds because of your evil behavior, but now he has reconciled you by Christ's physical body through death to present you holy in his sight without blemish and free from accusation. Oh, and free from accusation. Oh, pigia tu bwana makofi mazuri. Si upigia tu bwana makofi mazuri. But now he has reconciled you. The Bible says, verse 21 of Colossians, chapter number 1. Once you were alienated, once you were separated from God, and we were enemies in our mind. But now, hallelujah, we have been reconciled through the body of Jesus Christ. May the Lord God bless each one of us. Let us understand the purpose of reconciliation. Hallelujah. Before you, God is reconciling the present things on earth and even things in heaven back to himself. So let us be reconciled back to our maker.
Amen.
You know, many are talking of heaven. Yes, heaven is there. But it is to them that Christ has saved. It is heaven is for them that are born again. Heaven is for them that have been reconciled by Christ in Jesus' mighty name. Praise be to the name of the living God. If your sister has sinned against you, make a point of coming together. Make a point of reconciling. We should not live as enemies anymore. Praise be to the name of the living God. Even our politics should not separate us. We should not be separated by the politics. We should not be separated by the VMAs. Hallelujah. We should not be separated with the political parties. We should not be separated with the tribes line. Or with your background where you have been born from. No matter, it doesn't matter the language you are speaking. We should all be reconciled back to our God. And the language of our maker is unity. The language of our maker is love. The language of our maker. You cannot see someone going naked. You have to clothe him in Jesus' name. The language of heaven. You have to feed the hungry in Jesus' name. The language of heaven is we have to love one another in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, in the mighty name of Jesus. Shall we stand on our feet? Let's stand on our feet, brethren. And I want us to pray. And I want us to ask God today that we have to be new in Christ Jesus. Whosoever is in Christ Jesus, he is a new creation. The old is fading away. The new has come. And them that are new in Christ today, they love their neighbors. Oh, they love their children. They love their husbands. They love one another. In the mighty name of Jesus, let us be reconciled back to our Maker. Let us be reconciled back to Christ today. Oh, the message of the cross. The Bible says it is foolishness to them that are perishing, but to them that love Christ, it is the power of God. It is the wisdom of God to reconcile us back to our Maker. When you are reconciled back to your Maker, you have everything. That is why I love the presence of the living God. In the presence of our Maker, we have all that we need. We have all the riches that we need. We have all the finances that we need. In the presence of our Maker, oh, we have joy in the name of Jesus. The blessings of the Father, the blessings of Jesus, they have no regrets. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The blessings of our Maker, they have no regrets. You will not regret why you are born. You will not regret why you went to a school. You will not regret why you are born to be a Kenyan. You will not regret your background. But so long as you are reconciled back to your Maker, we have all that we need. In the mighty name of Jesus. I love how the Malachi ends the chapter. That God is sending Elijah. God is sending a prophet. And the work of this prophet is to reconcile the hearts of the fathers to their children. The hearts of the children to their parents. Or else there is a curse that is coming. Heavenly Father, I praise you. Let's lift our hands as we worship in the name of Jesus. Let's lift our hands even as we pray in the name of the living God. Heavenly Father, I thank you because of your word. This message of reconciliation. Let your Holy Spirit enable each one of us to be reconciled back to our Maker, to be reconciled back to our Heavenly Father. Let the hearts of the children be reconciled back to their fathers. Let the hearts of the parents be reconciled back to their children in the mighty name of Jesus. Let there be unity even in our leadership in Jesus' name. Let there be unity, yes, even in our country today. Let there be unity even in the Church of Christ today in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us be reconciled back to our Maker. We ask your forgiveness in Jesus' name. To them that are speaking hatred, oh God, we speak the blessings of love today in the mighty name of Jesus. We speak peace of the living God. We speak shalom in the mighty name of the living God. To them that are going hungry, Jehovah God, we speak that you give us a heart of sharing our blessings together with them, even to feed the hungry in Jesus' name. To them that are walking hungry, oh God, oh, to them that are going naked, Jehovah God, give us a heart of reconciliation that we can clothe them that are walking naked in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us preach love in the name of the living God. To them that are not born again, I speak the blessings of salvation, reconciliation through your Lord Jesus Christ in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of the living God, we take power and authority. We rebuke the spirit of discord, the spirit of hatred, the spirit of disharmony. We render you powerless in Jesus' mighty name. We pull down the strongholds of hell, the strongholds of the enemy. We render you powerless in Jesus' name. And I bless our viewers today. I bless them that are here today. I bless the work of their hands in Jesus' name. To them that are sick, Jehovah God, I speak the blessings of healing in their life in Jesus' mighty name. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh yes, them as many as having their needs today. Jehovah, may you meet their needs in Jesus' name. May you open doors, floodgates of heaven. Bless them in the mighty name of Jesus. I bless the offering of your people. I bless the tithe of your people. I bless every seed they are sowing in the mighty name of the living God. Bless the work of their hands. Enlarge their territories in the mighty name of Jesus. They are going out is blessed, Jehovah God. And they are coming back is blessed in Jesus' name. In the the mighty name of Jesus, our children are blessed. Yes, them that are in boarding schools, oh God. Oh, we rebuke the devourer, the spirit of burning schools, the spirit of burning schools, the spirit of burning dormitories, the spirit of bringing disunity in our colleges, in any institution. We render you powerless in Jesus' name. Peace be still in our colleges. Peace be still in our schools. In the mighty name of Jesus. You spirit of destruction, we render you powerless in Jesus' name. And we speak love. We speak harmony. In the mighty name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, I bless you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Them that are sick today, we speak the blessings of healing, the benefit of healing in each one's body in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. We bless you and we honor you. We thank you for the reading of your word. We thank you for the message of the cross. For us, to us it is power. It is power. It is redemption. It is full of healing. It is full of love. We bless you and we honor you. For it is in Jesus' mighty name we pray and give thanks. Somebody say amen. Pigia tu bwana makofi mazuri. And thank you our brethren online. And thank you wherever you are. The Lord God bless you. And the Lord God keep you. You are going out is blessed. Our contacts are there. You can still follow even after this. In Jesus' mighty name. And to them that are present here with us, I want us to bring our offerings. Let's bring our offerings together. And even as we give our offerings to them that are viewing us online, you can use the contacts there to bring our offerings into the sanctuary today. In the mighty name of Jesus, give your sacrificial giving. Give the blessings in the name of the living God. In the mighty name of Jesus. And to as many as are sowing a seed, I want you to lift up your offering wherever you are. Toa sadaka yako na uweke kwa mikono yako tuiombe pamoja. So let's give out our offering. And I want you to raise your hands high. And let's bless our offering today. In the mighty name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, I thank you for the sacrificial giving of your people today. I thank you for the blessings you are giving unto us. And for the many blessings you have blessed us, O Lord. We are taking a portion of it. And we are bringing into your sanctuary today. And we are sowing a seed, Jehovah God. We are bringing our tithe into your storehouse today, that we may lack nothing in Jesus' name. Bless us a 30-fold. Bless us a 60-fold. Bless us even 100-fold. In Jesus' mighty name. Father, I bless you and I honor you. For it is in Jesus' mighty name we pray and give thanks. In Jesus' mighty name. Somebody say amen. Shupigie tu bwana makofi mazuri. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Jonita Post. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. I want us to praise the Lord. Nataka tuchukue microphone.